This is Eternal Blade, and welcome to part 52 of the Space Marine Thunderfire Cannon tutorial. This will be the last modeling tutorial for this. So effect to it only, center to object for our little bird thing we got going on here. Just center it up there. Perspective. Take that off. It actually looks really nice. Really, really nice. All right. Assign it gray, black. Alright. Next, unhide everything. Okay. And delete all these extra things we don't need. Leave this guy in there. And make a cylinder. About yay big top. Just attempt to center it up here. This is our rendering platform. Just a nice little way to finish things off. Okay, line it up there. And this is another reason why I rigged up these little suckers, because now we have to use them. Just rotate. Amazingly, they're really close. So, assign this a gray material. And give this maybe 60, 80 sides, you know. Don't go easy on it. It's a prime part here. And that looks pretty nice. Okay. Select the top, chamfer, a nice little rounded chamfer here. Now what you're going to want to do, build a circle, okay, align it to that cylinder we just built, go to the top view, perspective, actually, raise it up, now make a target camera, select the target, align it to there, select the camera, animation, constraints, path constraint. If you go into your four view here and you make one of these the camera, and you can see it'll automatically do a little rotation thing. Now, this is kind of hard to get right, so just bear with me here. Increase the radius a bit. What you want to do is close enough where you get all the details, but far enough away where you don't miss anything crucial. I'm actually going here for a second. Manually select this target, because the target is what the camera looks at. So let's just move it up a bit. Okay. Do a quick scrub. That's looking pretty good, but let's bring it up a bit more, I think. There we go. Next. Depending on what kind of resolution you want or what kind of video you're doing, I prefer to do around maybe 300 frames. I actually bring the frame count down to 300 exact. Or else you get this little frame that just kind of appears. Actually, either way, because it doesn't matter. That frame is somewhere else. Okay, you see how that happens? What you gotta do is go here, and then somehow find your path constraint, which is probably on the camera. Here we go. And see this animated thing right here? it's right here, just drag it over to frame 300. That way you'll have a nice slow turnaround. 300 at 30 frames per second, it's 10 seconds, so that's it's pretty decent. Let's see. And your lighting, you should be your default scan line, advanced lighting, light tracer. You can turn the initial sampling up to 32 subdivisions at 2. This way it'll make it clearer, you should say. Let's see here. When you're rendering out your video, make sure you go to active time segment. Choose whatever resolution you want. For this kind of thing, it's going to take a while, like an overnighter, depending on your computer power, about 800 by 600 maybe. Make sure you save your file somewhere. I have had problems where I forgot to save it, even though there's a warning box. I was tired and I lost it. So, yeah. I believe that's it, but. Oh. 0 to 300. Just double checking I didn't miss anything here. Some depth, who cares? Alright, let me just Space Marine Thunder Dark Cannon, final video. Or final, I guess is good. Okay, this is a big investment in time, I'm telling you. Hit render, let's watch one frame and make sure it's good, and no, it's not good. Cancel. Make sure you kick camera. Yes, very important. Overwrite. We'll see what it does. It should take a while. Okay, and you can see we have some really nice lines here. You could give that a smooth modifier if you want. Don't have to. I actually think we might do that, but hey, that's what this is for. Just checking. Render. Goes kind of slow because the recording software, but nothing I can do about it. And I'd love to see some of your guys' final renders or how far you've gotten. Have any questions, feel free to comment. Yeah, we did a nice job here. Nice job. So, let me actually cancel this while we're here. Perspective. And just maximize that. Do this thing. So we can take off that UW map, we don't need it. What am I looking for? Not auto smooth, mesh smooth. Just smooth, actually. And I'm actually going to render out a little frame here. I just want to see if it fixed. And it did, I believe. You don't see any of those things. So, just make sure you go to ATS. And then, you have to have the camera viewable. Camera 1, hit render. And you should be good to go. I'll have one final tutorial showing you the rendered product, and maybe some other tips for texturing, or you know, various other things you can do.